earlier broadcast today, and I would be curious to see if IBP Power elect to do such a thing, or if they're going to go for a passive mid once again. But they will start on the CT side here, so it won't be long until we find out.
Yeah, it's always going to be nice to see how the pistol actually turns out, because teams can play it vanilla. They can go for some vanilla, you know, start just plain. Not, I wouldn't say boring, but just plain. Or they can do something bit nuts. Here we're actually seeing a B contact play, it seems like. Just checking out the map here, it seems like they are just slowly edging towards B storage. Pretty silent. Actually, they're making noise now, so it's not so much a B contact play anymore, as they do have one man who is perhaps positioned towards going through vents. But generally, big posture towards B right now. And IBP Power, depends how they react here. If they overcommit towards B, if Savage are just trying to fool them here.
We've got a bunch of random names from IBP Power. So I have no idea who Paulie is, who KZA is, who Mr. Brightside is for the time being. We'll have to work that out, which isn't great when you're a commentator, but
yep.
Never mind.
We'll just have to figure it out. Yeah, I did do a... well, either way, hold that thought. We are jumping into the action here as we do see Savage taking the B bomb site by storm. It was lying in wait for so long. Finally, they hit the switch there and go for the aggression, but they're going to get shut down by IBP Power. And I'm just trying to think, because I'm pretty sure I did do a cash game at some point with IBP Power. I don't know if how much they switched positions around. So
it was like last week, wasn't it?
Well, no, it was quite a long time ago. So it's very likely that I wouldn't be able to judge their positions based on that video, because they probably would have switched it up. So I wouldn't like to hazard a guess here. But perhaps the chat can inform us or tweet us exactly as to what's going on there. Either way, we're going to see a bit of an A split action coming up here from Savage. Just straight up, you know, just with the pistols. There's not much investment.
That meaty grenade.
It's going to be going to have to be two ecos regardless. They decided not to actually get any kind of buy here. Not even you know, some...
they got some smokes. They got some smokes down. The whole purpose there was a quick bomb plant. They did get the guy onto the site, but he did get taken out even despite being in the smoke there. So.
But they have to double eco twice anyway, so usually like going for a buy, because if you look at their money now, they can definitely buy and still afford a buy next round. Like, they can buy something, you know, some and they did do so actually. They got some P250s, CZs. They're just not investing in any armor, which you can do on one of the rounds if you go for a full save on the following one. But we do see obviously now they're just spreading out along the A towards A door, and also, you know, one got caught by Mr. Brightside there. Do more as he tried to move in towards A main. So, and the bomb is actually over towards B, so this looks like a very, you know, standard, very dirty kind of like throw everyone at A and this guy tries to sneak into B. But I don't know if that kind of stuff works against teams as good as IBP Power. It's rare to see that work against the top level teams, but they are swinging back towards B, so.
Looks like AZK has temporarily left the building, and hopefully he'll be back with us very shortly. So it has become a 4-on-4 for that purpose, and that is going to be an open bomb site there for the Savage team, so a bit of luck in having a disconnect from one of the IBP plays will allow them to get that bomb down. Let's see if they can even get around here.
Not the best plant in the world there for Savage, but they felt a bit pressured in getting that down. So Skadido going to make his way through. Actually going to get the kill onto Relic there. Got Ryan's looking over from Bentley. You're also going to get dropped. So it's like it's just Glorian left over here. Brightside's going to catch him off guard, and relatively clean up there for the end of the round there for them. What's that?
Relatively clean up.
Yeah, I know, right? I know, right? That's pretty awesome, isn't it? I've been doing pretty well so far, but perhaps, you know, that's a sign of some fatigue. But looks like we are going to have a pause right now. It's up, and here we go. We see the AWP being bought on the side of IBP Power as well. There's a text all over there. So obviously Mr. Brightside is swag. We worked that out with our awesome detective skills, and Steel is being obviously replaced with Paulie at the moment. So Skadoodle with his AWP. Let's actually see if we can check out the positions here. We already lose Hades there. Dade's going to take him out. And so very short-lived run with that AWP. And it's going to be even actually now, as it seems that IBP Power actually pushed the door, which is not the most common strategy, something you don't see very often in Europe either. And it actually works out very well for IBP Power, able to get some kills. We see that Dumour kind of run tail between legs, has the bomb, and they're going to be forced to make a play towards B here. I mean, they don't have the men to really get themselves up mid, And already A has been kind of shut down, so it really just leaves B left for them. You can see they're slowly edging towards this bomb site. And I by power. Who is the man here for I by power? So look, they're going to make their way in. We're going to do more. First men onto the site. And it's going to be actually Pauly who's just chilling up there on the site. He's going to go down. Does take down one player first. And I by power. Do skadoodle furthest away. But they got plenty of time to really just, you know, chill. Get this setup going on this retake. And if they do it right, with the numbers advantage, they should be able to make this work. Savage, you never know what could happen. They're trying to go for the wallbangs there through the metal door. And all up through the upper area, actually, straight down onto the bomb site. And AZK going to make his way through the vent rooms. And there you go, going to take down Valens. And it's, it seems like a relatively simple, well coordinated retake.
Yeah, so unfortunate that JDM fell so early on into that round and really limited Savage compared to what they were planning to do. JDM is the man with the AWP for that team. And we'll see what the, sorry, Hades.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, I was like, I know I'm really tired right end. Now, but is
yeah.
he saying,
James? I was like, wait a minute. Am I talking about the right match here? Look at that wallbang. This is what I'm talking about. The Americans know their wallbangs, especially on cash. They just know all these kind of wallbangs we don't really see from the European team. So it's really great to see the differences when we watch the American matches here.
Oh, look at the angle there. Just look at that beautiful distraction. Perfect play there from AZK and Pauly. AZK drawing attention and gets one kill. And after the attention's gained, Pauly peeks out from another angle. It's beautiful to watch, beautiful to witness. And now we just got two players left for Savage. So this buy round is not going to go so well for them. Going to make a play on A here. Just going to get shut down. Can't even get out onto the bomb site there, of course. And of course, the money is going to be pretty screwed now for Savage. Or actually, no, it's not. They've lost so many row now. They got, you know, huge, huge consecutive round loss bonus on the money, and they're able to, you know, put in the buy. So let's see what they're able to pull together this round. You know, got a couple of Galils, very limited grenades, but they can get the rifles and the armor, which is the important part. So let's see what happens here. Hades, you know, the smoke over the red, and it looks like they're not going to go for a mid play. Again, you know, mid plays, usually passive or very delayed from American teams generally, from what we've seen, at least on the FACEIT League matches here for North America. And I'm apparently just holding very steady at the moment, waiting for a move to be made. And if they go on mid, they're just going to gun down Hades. Now go the grenades.
All about the bomb sites, the American cash players, from what we're seeing here. Only one person building a defense in mid, and going to have some help potentially from the A-bomb site, but Daze has gone back towards CT, so just going to give up mid altogether.
B-split is in the works here, and if they manage... Oh no, he does! Threat would be so mad! Threat would be so mad! Relic's right now going and peeking short like that, and they're going to go for the B-split now. Down maybe one player, they could be up one player instead, but they're going to get the really fast pick onto AZK. Pauly, oh no! A miss throw on the grenade, going to grenade himself to help.
He's been paid off.
More. Take him out. 3-on-3 right now, Daze coming in from up top, and Valens and Dumor stuck pretty much in their positions. It's not a great plant, it's not an open plant, so they've got to be really careful about this. I don't think it's an open plant anyway, we have to double check that. Either way, Valens and Dumor are going to be trying to lock down everything from the vent room right now. This is going to be the setup they're going to try to run to defend this. Must be an open plant if they're taking these positions. And Skadoodle checking the site. Yeah, just open enough here from the vent room. Skadoodle, though, going to cut off the angle on to Dumor. And that's going to be another round for I by power. But Savage can keep buying up if they want. They got the max money loss bonus. Round loss bonus. Consecutive round loss bonus. There we go. It's such a tongue twister. I should just practice that at night. I should say it over and over again.
Yeah, if that works for you, then be my guest.
I'm sure it would.
So we've got the buy coming out here from Savage. See if they can change things around in this seventh round here. 6-0 to I buy power.
No flashes, only smokes. That's quite a big deal, actually. Flashes are really important here, but of course their money's so stretched. They feel like smokes, though, for whatever their plan is this round, is going to be the most helpful. They do have the bomb towards B at the moment, and so I doubt we're going to see loads of smokes, you know, flying over towards A from the T spawn side.
Interestingly, I by power, they just run straight into B and then shoot the vent and boost up there. as opposed to Virtus Pro, who do it on their way into the B-bomb site, shooting it through the shutter, which is more inconspicuous and, you know, sneaky.
It's like Hades actually going to toss a smoke over. They do have the bomb still on the B-side, but with these smokes, they might be actually able to make some picks here and really sell this fake. If they can really sell this fake, this is going to be really powerful. It's like some good damage done through the wall. They're actually Swag not moving back at all. Hades just going to gun him down. Swag very...
I think he was flash at the
very
time.
Very set to say that. But look, it looks like Overpower have actually worked out that there is still a lot of reason to be stuck on the B bomb site here, even though the frags are happening over towards the A side as well. In goes AZK from the vent route, or the vents rather, and it looks like he's not going to get much more than one kill just yet before Savage do retreat back onto the site. But they've yet to get the bomb down, and this is a lot of time here that Overpower are getting to go for the rotation, even going to catch some terrorist players on rotation as well. The bomb is planted at the back of the site here. What are we going to see here now from Daze and Skadoodle, both in M4? Looks like Glorin going to take down Skadoodle, so the AWPer has been dealt with. And a great little catch on to Daze right there with the AK-47. And Savage finally pick up their first round, and what a nice round it was.
Welcome to the scoreboard, Savage. They do manage to save the AWP, currently on relics. Might throw it to Hades, we'll see if he... does that, or if he's going to go for the peak. No, Hades is going to pick up the AWP, and plenty of money in the bank for iBuyPower, so they will get the AWP on Skadoodle. So we'll see where Hades is taking his one. Looks like he's going to go towards door, and Skadoodle going to be covering B with his teammates in the vents as backup as well. He should be looking at mid as Skadoodle does have the angle out towards the T side of B.
Nice catch on today's there over at the barrels, toxic barrels, and that's a great job done right now. May even want to consider just falling back unless his teammates do actually execute the A play. It's like, oh, Paulie's gonna get counter boosted here. Let's see what they can find with this. They're not expecting it. Great kill onto Valens there and fall back after the frag.
That's a bomb down as well. They know where the bomb is. They've seen the bomb.
So they won't be fooled by this in the shenanigans there by the AWPer, Mades. And Glorin going to take down Paulie, and maybe that information of seeing the bomb was actually a negative thing after all, giving them the confidence to try to move forwards towards it. And it's a 3-on-4 at the moment in favor of Savage. Make that a 3-on-3 now. Swag does find a kill on Hades, who was still hanging around Squeaky Door with that AWP, and in they go onto A. But look at this. Overpower, they're all over this right now. Redick in a really, really good position. Going to take down AZK. Glorin looking... take down Swag, there is the frag, and Skadoodle gonna fall as well, and there you go, nice little execution there from Savage.
So it looks like they didn't bother to pick up the AWP that round. Are they gonna go for rifles here? Straight up rifles, it seems that's gonna be the case. So changing up their tactics a little bit here, going for more dynamic play, allowing Savage to engage more enemies at the same time than an AWP might necessarily do.
In they go, just a straight up B play coming in right now as Valens leads the charge through the vent room. And there it is, AZK instantly taken down. There's one more play on the site, it's going to be Paulie. And great little flash there to help him out get a free frag onto Valens. And they need to get that bomb down really fast. Right now, it looks like Overpower all over them right now. The bomb isn't even necessarily an issue because Overpower's players are swarming them at this point. Looks like it's a 4-on-2 now. Swag and Skadoodle left over for iBuyPower. Swag pretty far away, just moving through mid at the moment, so this is going to be very difficult. So very well played for Savage to get the kills they needed in a timely fashion on the B side of the map. And right now you can see that Skadoodle is just set up to try to take some exit kills here, and Swag's going to do the same. You know, moving in from T-spawn towards B storage, just going to hold a sneaky position. And let's see if he can find anyone. They are looking for him, though. They know some of these, you know, sneaky spots. Look at this, Hades. He knows. Okay, well, he had a very good idea, at least. He was very wary. And it's like Skadoodle goes down without much trouble either. So they're going to eliminate those weapons for iBuyPower. And all of a sudden, it's Savage who finally forced iBuyPower to an eco. iBuyPower, who had actually won, I think it was 5 rounds in a row, if I'm not mistaken.
Solid 5-0.
Or even maybe it was a 6-0, in fact. Was it, perhaps? Either way, Savage definitely coming back here, and they're going to get their first kind of, you know, quote-unquote, you know, free rounds in the eco. But of course, it doesn't always go like that in CSGO. But we'll see how iBuyPower play this.
iBuyPower with one flashbang, so we'll see how they use this. And there it goes. No kills yet. Glorin taking out two of them. Leaving him in a 5-on-3 here with a full buy for Team Savage, but we'll see.
Oh, he gets behind him. And Hades is not going to spot this at all. I think it's Godudo indeed. Oh, he's behind another one. He gets the knife. Oh, he doesn't go for the knife. He just goes for the single shot with the pistol there. And I got to say, I've never been more convinced of a moment when you should knife someone, James.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, regardless,
he's like hugging him.
Regardless of how he gets that kill, he's going to bring out the weapon afterwards. So. Yeah. Probably worth it, you know. The knife is worth 5 times the amount of money he just got from that P250 kill.
Either way, we shouldn't, I guess, throw criticism too heavily towards that. We're just hungry for the knife frags, man.
It's another marginal situation. You can go for the knife if you want to, or you can just go for the pistol.
And Dave's gonna get one side here now, and there is the round for Savage. Pretty free. That's gonna really have a massive, you know, positive effect on their economy. You can see how much it's really booming now, having not lost really anyone. So now IBO Power, it's on them right now. They got the double AWP setup. So where are they going to put these AWPs? Is it A and B and 3 on mid? I don't know. It looks like Skadoodle's going to go towards mid, and we got AZK on B right now, and there's actually a lot of traffic towards B. Can he get the shot here on the pixel? Ooh, and he does do it through the flash. Well done. He's got to get out of there really quickly. They're going to be rushing him down, although he does have help. Paulie rushing through the vents. This is the aggressive mid play at its best. You get that support when you need it as the AWPer on B, and now AZK doesn't have to worry anymore as things calm down in B storage.
So that two fast picks there for IBO Power leaves them in a 5-on-4 now that Hades has taken down Skadoodle in mid. Let's see if they can use mid to pincer B. There are two players remaining on the A bombsite for IBO Power, so if Savage can act faster, they could take the B bombsite almost uncontested.
And Paulie is going to be in a really tough position very soon because it looks like the execution may be nigh on this B bombsite. He's up on the site itself, tossing out those nades. In comes the Molotov. It's burning him alive. He's going to be careful. And he's actually going to get pushed out of that position into the reticle of Dumont. He's going to execute poorly right there. So 3-on-3 now with the bomb. It should be going down very, very soon here. Going to be behind those boxes. So it's not an open plant, which is always, you know, something to consider for how the players have to understand how to cover that bomb. And Dumont there, he just catches ahead of Daze, trying to make his way through the vents. And Hades and Dimo with a really nice setup here in the vent room, and they've got a player on the site as well. So this is fairly ideal there for Savage at the moment.
That grenade landed right in front of Dimo and only did 10 HP of damage to him. So a bit weird, but never mind. And
good round Savage, from Hades.
Yeah, they take another round here. And this is getting closer and closer now. You know, you look at the betting on CSGO Lounge, etc., e-gaming bets, I think Savage were 9%. They've got 5 of 11 rounds right now on the T side. The less favored side. Yeah, cash here, so they're not looking too bad.
It's supposed to be, you know, it's supposed to be one of their better maps and, you know, one of the best choices for them against IBO Power. And we're starting to see, you know, that really come into play. They are managing to pull some good rounds out. And we can see their execution, you know, is pretty hot actually as well. So let's see what they're able to get here. It should be, you know, of course, it should be the free round, but you never know with these pistols. 5-7 for Dave, they're trying to force the issue, but Dave, you know, might think twice about this now. I mean, through that choke point and everything is probably quite disconcerting of a situation.
Got to be careful now. Hades is looking for him, and he's standing right in the middle, probably trying to make it out of A main, but didn't manage to. And the wall bangs are real. Honestly, you could, when the Americans are playing cash, you could just make a highlight reel of just wall bang of the day. You know, we've seen so many of them today already. It's been really great to watch, and I'd like to see the Europeans pick up some of these angles.
And looks like a very clean round there for Savage. And let's have a look at their money. Police should get down there. Does get a quick little kill there before he does die. We can check out the money now and we can see what the situation is. We can see that bank is really building for Savage. They've got quite a buffer. So IBO Power actually in really dangerous territory here now because, well, actually we're so late actually into the first half now that the money isn't really a huge deal. So obviously IBO Power don't want to lose this, otherwise, you know, they are on eco again. So I believe as they all bought up fully. But let's see where Hades and Hades is actually at the moment. We do see Skadoodle very aggressive there. Hades peeking him towards vent room, so he's waiting patiently for CT to go for a bit of a peek here. And if Hades is quick, he can get the kill. Those are some precise grenades right there. Paulie down, about 30 health there. And there you go. Glory just runs in just with the flash there. Not much support, but wow, Hades with a fantastic shot through the smoke. It's going to even things up a little bit. Obviously, they've got to be really afraid now. They don't know how many people are behind that AWPer. There could be quite a lot for all they know. So they've got to play it very, very cautiously. In fact, it's going to trigger a response for rotation from Ivo Power from A.
We've got two CTs on the site to defend this bomb pusher, which is going to make it hard for Savage to breach, especially as we have them coming from upper and lower CT as well. And a great play from Daze on the site, using the barrels to his advantage, exposing as little as possible of himself. And that's a really good hold there for IBP, bring it to 7-6 here with two rounds remaining.
Yeah, really, really important round there. You can see, obviously, how weak their money is. That if they were, you know, going for the buy afterwards, they wouldn't really be able to. So this is, you know, a really big round for them. As Savage aren't going to be up against Nico now. It's like Hades is lining up a grenade here. And that's going to be towards the back boxes, I think, on the A-bomb site, by the looks of things. And, of course, that's going to allow his, you know, exit through the squeaky door to be a little bit easier, if that's what they're going for. And, wow, Hades executing Skadoodle at range. And, yeah, there's the smoke grenade we saw thrown by Hades there by the back boxes, by Swag. And they are just taking the picks left and right now. It's not even a contest at this point. AZK, the last man standing, over at mid against five players here from Savage.
So we're looking at 7-7 here for Savage, unless something crazy happens, like a mass disconnect from Savage pressing the wrong button. So two quick picks for KZA, but Dumour does get the... Sorry, AZK. Dumour does get the trade kill there, and it is the last round. Savage going to be able to full buy, so those deaths won't really matter. I buy power with a hope and a prayer, two rifles, a CZ, a deagle, and a 5-7.
All right, once again, we're going to check out Hades and see how he plays his AWP aggressively. Again, looking for those timings. It's like he's not going to go for any timings, just some idle shots through the grate there. And the metal shutter. And it does seem like they are just going to go for some slow picks here to see what they can find at the start of the round. You can see, obviously, the buy is very, very awkward here for IBP. They only have two rifles, and the deagle, a CZ, and the is that a PT-50? I'm not sure. Either way, it's not
5-7.
5-7. I wonder. It doesn't look like a USP or PT-1000. It's not a PT-50 either. But yeah, 5-7, that makes a lot of sense. And... You know, Savage are quite aware of this situation for IBP, so they're really taking this very slow. Using that time to their advantage. Poorly going to make the aggressive move out onto B storage. Gets denied, but actually the trade does come in though from AZK. Skadoodle going to take down Dumour there on mid. So this is actually going quite well so far for IBP. The real push is coming in on A now. Can they handle it?
Golden Nose coming in to clear the back of the bomb site, but there's no CT there just yet. Swag is holding a different position, but... manages to he gets tagged as he runs into fire. It's a really unfortunate combination there for him, and it's going to be a 2v1 with AZK coming from A main here. Unknown position for him, for the two terrorists, and they're setting up for a crossfire position, so hopefully they'll get a trade kill.
Oh, sick shot there from AZK on the 1-on-2, goes for the fake defuse there, going to work his way around the smoke. There's a few seconds to kill here, and he's just got to go for the chase. He might be able to do this. He's close enough. Keep going for it. Oh, barely able to make it happen. Relic's going to make the frag on AZK, and that is actually Savage finishing the first half with a one-round advantage, 8-7 for Savage. So, wow, big result there, and looking at how people have been betting, a lot of people are going to be... biting their nails right now, James.
Yeah, I feel like there could be some death threats incoming here for the players. But, you know, you got to be prepared to lose your skins if you bet them. So sometimes the teams win, sometimes the teams lose. It is 8-7 at the moment, so anything can happen in this second half. But I think there is going to be a bit of nail biting here on the CSGO Lounge. So we're going to have a brief pause here, and then we'll continue with the proceedings. So looking at the scoreboard here, we've got Hades, Glorin, and Dumour putting in work for the Savage team here. 17, 13, and 10 kills. Valenza and Relics with 6 kills and 6 kills, respectively. Skadoodle doing well on the CT side. I was about to switch over to the T side with 13 kills. Dazed and AZK also with double figures, and Paulie and Swag kind of lagging behind at the moment, but you know, it seems it's basically all fair and square. And just going to have a quick reconnect here for Swag, and then we'll be hopefully proceeding with the rest of the match.
That is the hope, James. But today we have been very unlucky. Hopefully our streak changes.
Yeah, today the internet gods have said no. So
no Counter-Strike for you today.
Yeah, although we've had some great matches, but you know, been a bit of stopping and starting in this one. So hopefully this won't take too long.
All right, well, either way, Savage, I think they are blowing some minds right now. And to be honest, we're seeing some great individual plays from them. I mean, we're seeing some really nice aim overall, some good tactics, some decent strategy as well. So overall, you know, Savage are pulling up to this game against iBuyPower with the full package to deal with iBuyPower. And so far, it's going pretty well. I wouldn't like to exactly hazard a guess just yet where it's going wrong for iBuyPower, but Savage are definitely hitting some of the shots that they need to hit. They're, you know, winning some of the aim duels, and we're not seeing iBuyPower outperforming them there. So overall, it's definitely looking fantastic for Savage right now. I don't know what their CT half is going to look like, but now I'm really curious.
Yeah, I think for Savage on the T side, they had the freedom to just cause as much mayhem as possible. But now I think the CT side might be more difficult for them. You know, iBuyPower, a team of arguably more prepared strats. You know, they went half and half on the CT side, but on the T side, they can really get to work on some kind of set aggression on this map. So we'll see what they have to offer when Swag returns, hopefully shortly.
You know what? American teams are always really good on LAN. Have you ever noticed that? They always are very strong on LAN.
Well, how? I mean,
on the pressure situations. I guess iBuyPower lately have had some shaky LAN performances, but maybe this is a bit of confirmation bias coming out from me, because when I pay attention to American teams, it's because they're actually doing well, maybe. I'm not sure. I'm just going to retract that statement slowly and walk away from the issue.
I mean, swiftly on.
But generally, you know, I think it's a bit of an American thing. You know, they're very, very confident. Definitely, they're not ever going to downplay their own abilities. And I think that's kind of attitude and sometimes charisma really shines through from the American players when you see them at LAN, and just by watching them and seeing their, you know, self-belief, you know, often see the confidence, it irradiates from them, and I think that really gives them a very positive image at LAN regardless of performance sometimes. But definitely you always know that you're in for a tough match when you're against them if you meet them on a LAN. And either way, looks like we have Glory back on the server, so that's good. We need him. Need him to get this going again.
And, okay, here we go. So let's see what pistol strat iBuyPower are going to offer us here in the second half of this final match of today.
All right,
oh,
so we're going to get
the wrong button.
We're going to get ourselves an old tab just to complete everything. You know, that's how we complete the night of awesome luck. But either way, 8-7 now. So Savage going into the pistol round on the CT side. Let's see what they got to show us here against iBuyPower. And likewise for iBuyPower, let's see what they got going for them on the side of the terrace here. It looks like Hades is going to pick off Dazed with a nice little catch with that PD-1000. And here we go, into the bomb site. They go iBuyPower, taking this by storm right now. Jumping with the Glocks. And look at that relics just popping out from the back boxes there. Looks like Skadoodle's going and AZK going to return the kills to get the bomb down on the A bomb site. Glorian at 1v3 with the CZ. There's only so many bullets in that thing, though. He's only got 24 in total. Hasn't rattled off any just yet, but that might provide quite the problem here moving forwards for Glorian. Got a player in main, one back boxes and one on the bomb itself. And it's looking at the first kill there. Can't make it happen. Paulie going to lock it down. And there we go. We've got iBuyPower actually taking the pistol round on the second half. Definitely. That's definitely going to alleviate some of the stress.
Yeah, we'll see what their anti-eco strats is here, how they try and stay together and lose as few guns as possible versus a potential CZ strat from the opposing team. But we're not seeing any CZs right now. We're just seeing P250s. And really, the increase to $200 has really changed the use of the CZ. And I'm looking forward to seeing the stats in the coming months from Valve and in how much the gun has decreased in use.
I like this, actually. We can see on the overview, there's not much happening right now. So we can actually see the little stack on B where they're like, one guy is like baiting the other in the corner. I like that. So I don't think we're going to see a B play, but it would be quite cute just to see this little setup working. But they realize now that most of the traffic's towards A, and they're going to go and initiate the rotation. And
yeah, it's not even P250s. They've just gone for straight P2000. So it's a maximum eco here from Savage. Probably looking to pick up some AWPs during the buy round here in the future.
Maybe even scars as well. I mean, they might be one of those teams that are just like, yeah, we're just gonna get
buy round scars. Let's go. And again, no purchases here yet on the CT side. So they're just gonna go for as much economy on the buy round as possible and concede the other rounds, unless they get lucky. Although Dumour has bought Deagle, so it's broken ranks along with Glorin. Double Deagle here.
Yeah. But actually, the Scar is really good on A as well. If you want to hold it solo, it can actually be really sick if you've got loads of smokes to help you out from your teammates. It can be pretty good. But either way, it's like Savage are, you know, kind of stacking the B bomb site right now and working their way around B storage. And they're quickly going to figure out exactly what's going on. And they're probably going to say, Relics, you've got some incoming right now, man, as they don't see anything on their side. 5-7 good for one kill on today's just before Relics gets taken down. But that's pretty good damage done, actually. Iber Power, they're pretty weak right now. It's like Paulie and Skadoodle are actually kind of bleeding out. They need a paramedic right now. But there's no paramedics in this game. And it's like Swagger's going to take down Glorin right at the end there. So 10-8 there. And we're going to see now the Byron coming in for Savage. And we see the AWP there on Hades, as we've been used to. Again, quite curious whether or not they're going to go for two AWPs if they have, you know, another really capable AWPer who feels really confident to AWP on this map. But of course, Hades. Now, where is he going to go? Is he going to go B, A, mid? It's all viable. Looks like he's going to go for the B timing hit.
We'll see if he gets an early peek here from Paulie, who I think is on the other side, outside B. But Doesn't look like he's going to be...
He's going to go in, actually, a little bit. Okay, he's going to go back now. That's good. I was worrying for him, man. That is risky. That's really...
He's gone full Rambo.
That would be incredibly risky. All right, he's calmed down right now. He fell back. He's got some support there as well. We can see on the minimap, Savage are playing incredibly far back. Their player, who is on the CT connector, is actually not even inside the connector. He's like kind of... Well, he kind of is now, but he's is and isn't. It's like very close to CT spawn there, so not really wanting to peek his head into mid at all.
Right side, Swag. He got wall banged through Squeaky down to 6 HP.
And it does look like that's going to make their life a little bit harder. He just seems to be pressuring them though and keeping their options on A alive. He does get a pick there. That's going to really convince them off of the back of this mid play to you know, go and initiate. But there's that great smoke that we can see obscuring information down short. And you don't know if there's a player there or not. And Relics will soon find out that there is a Daze creeping up behind him. Going to take him in the back of the head. Dumour returning one onto Daze quickly. Skadoodle going to make himself a frag onto Dumour. So 3-on-4 situation in favor of Iber Parents. The bomb does go down. And Savage really need to try to go for this right now. Swag is really, really weak. And he's going to make his way in from the truck. He's got another mate over by the toxic barrels. They're going up the catwalk. Let's see what he can find. Lauren. Does manage to take down AZK. Wonderfully done. Paulie going to return it, though. Here goes Swag. Going to try to take out the defuser. Actually just sprays them both down. Really nicely done there by Swag.
Yeah, that's a nice play from Swag, especially after being shot down to 6 HP. Basically just hid in the door for most of the remainder of the round there and came out to kind of clutch it for his team. So really good play there, and that puts the Savage team back on an eco. We've got 3 Deagles coming out now, a CZ, and what looks like a P250. So we'll see what the CTs do with this.
So there's Skadoodle with the boost. Does drop Hades over in White Box, quickly scanning on for any, you know, close-up players there on mid. Doesn't see any, so they, you know, the information they can have from this is, okay, they can be on A, they can be on B. That's kind of what they know now. So they can get a peek onto A, they can maybe try to spot for some numbers, get an idea of how many nades are thrown in. Just figure things out here and get as much information as possible. But Skadoodle are going to eliminate Glorin in mid as well as he crosses back over through towards that A rotation. And Relic's going to sniff around, see what's up. Balance in Ven as well still, so... I'm probably just keeping it chill for now, using that clock to their advantage.
50 seconds remaining here. Bomb still in T-spawn. We've got Skadoodle just picking it up. And it's going to be going towards the B bomb site now. We've got two people on the A bomb site for Savage. One just falls. But Valens took down AZK in mid. And bomb's going to be a little bit patient here. 3v1. And they'll just go for all the frags rather than the plants. So 12-8 to Savage. Sorry, 12-8 to I by Power here. And we do have the auto sniper coming out for the CT side here on Valens.
I'm predicting on A. That's my prediction. Oh, is that two
double auto sniper? Wow, stars. They've gone shopping.
All right. Okay, well.
They've gone to the Chanel store and just blown all their money.
All right, so we have. Where is Glorin with his? Is he on mid? No, he's on B. He's on B. Are they both on B with the scars? They're both on B, double scar setup on B.
They have a crossfire scar setup. I think
I've
that's the
never
first time.
Seen anything like that. I gotta say, that is interesting. I'm lost for words. Ineffable. Either way, let's see what Ibo Power actually make of this themselves as they play this round. It looks so far as they're just, you know, taking the standard kind of spreading themselves across the width of their side of the map, trying to get that map control and wait out those grenades. Right now, actually, though, looks like they are moving towards A. And the scars seem to be holding tight still onto B. They're convinced, or at least they really want to
B push. It's going to be a really interesting retake with two auto snipers.
Yeah.
You know, the only thing I can think of more epic than double auto sniper crossfire setup, it would be a double negative crossfire setup. Imagine Heaton and Posse with negatives.
Dumo in a really, really important position here. He's got to really make a couple of frags as they try to make their way into the bomb site. Of course, there's three of them lined up. You can see that the door has been played with there, but no one's arrived just yet. But there go the grenades. Ooh, the spray from Relic was good, but not quite good enough in the face of Dazed. As the kills start coming in, we see AZK and Skadoodle, the last man standing here. Savage really doing a great job. They got both the scars alive still, making their way back in onto the retake situation. Great shot there from Valens, spamming that through the flash, and there you go. They clean it up, keep both scars alive, get the diffuse result.
So I wonder if Ibo Power are aware that it's a double auto sniper setup. They probably don't because they didn't see or have any encounters with the CTs while they were on the B bomb site. They're choosing to push the A bomb site, so they're aware of one. But are they going to know that the crossfire setup is real?
Honestly, I don't even know what, like that's so crazy. I can't wait to see what happens if they actually do run into it though. Either way, you know, Hades gonna, you know, flash himself up very close and smoke himself up very close to mid, so he can get a lot of info this way, and he is able also to catch any players who are boosted up mid. But you know, it seems like Overpower for the most part are just chilling on A main right now, and their options are very open for the entire map at this point. Obviously, A does look pretty good from the overview, from what we can see. Defense there isn't super huge. Did we just see some good damage? Yeah, we did. Hades just gunning one down. Paulie does get taken out. Days to snap the neck of Hades over by Short as they go for the site take. And there it is, bomb down. And now it's back to the double Scar Brothers from B. Here we go. It's like one gets dealt with pretty easily. And will he save the other one? He's still just checking, just in case. It's so strange that they're both at B, because I was making the point before that they're really good on A because you can spam so much through the smoke, because the A main always gets smoked off, and the T's usually use that as an opportunity to go to the right side of the doors, as well as of the opening, as also the left side. So you can come in from two angles and get an angle on forklift as well when it gets pop flash. So it's like you can just spam through and you can get a lot of damage, and you can even hold it pretty well on your own. Looks like we are getting actually some more crashes. Dumor's crashing, and that's good news. James?
It's good news that he crashed.
I don't know what to believe anymore, James. I don't know what to believe.
Yeah, been up for too long, I think.
Yeah.
Well, it's 13-9 here. Let's have a look at the money on the Savage team. I'm not sure how much Dumor had, but we'll see when he comes back. It looks like the Savage team are going to be able to force here and put some more weapons around that auto sniper rifle. So we'll see how much he has remaining when he returns to the server shortly. I think he's about 20, 30 seconds away. But Ibo Power, three rounds away from victory here. And we can see Dumour just returning to the server there. They've got a fair amount of money in the bank as well. We've got Days with 9,500, Skedoodle with 6. So they're looking good at present. And again, now we've got AZK's picked up the Auto Sniper on the T side that he took from the CT. So we're going to have an Auto Sniper face off here.
Maybe he like saw the Vanish shooting the Auto Sniper and he's like, man, that's a good idea. I should get one of those for myself. And perhaps that's what it was. That's always how I feel when I see someone using a SCAR. I'm like, oh, right, that weapon, that exists. That's pretty fun. They're pretty rich. They're pretty loaded. So why not blow it on some... Where are the Negevs, though? That's really what I want to see, though.
Yeah, I want to see Crossfire Negev 1B now.
The Crossfire Negev 1B. That's the only, like, step up.
Unstoppable, yeah.
The only step
up. Oh, you got to throw a Molotov in there as well. Just for good measure. We'll see where AZK is going to take his auto sniper. Just going to be having some shenanigans in mid at the moment. Skedoodle, in the meantime, it's going to go towards a main with his other teammates. What are you going to be looking towards? The
Juan League there onto Swag.
B bomb site.
From forklift onto A main. Already a good start here for Savage's defense. See, Hades rotating already. They're leaving one guy on B by himself. The bomb is down. Fiber power towards T spawn. Actually, it can go anywhere at this point. AZK just sitting there with that scar. They got a scar and an AWP left with one AK. So this would be pretty awkward to try to make something happen, as it's very difficult to move around with the sniper rifles. It's like AZK gonna find a kill onto Dumour there, as we have three players left for Fiber power, and with that frag, they go against four now.
So AZK, again, that's a nice pick from him in mid, but he won't have any CTs facing him anytime soon. Well, now he's shown his hand. But ends with his auto sniper, it's going to look to kind of even things up. The bomb site will, however, be going towards... The bomb will be going towards B, sorry. And the two players are going to meet up for Iber Power here and see if they can push the site.
Oh, and Hades does go down straight away. Interesting stuff there. He does get some good damage onto AZK. He's very low, 10 points of health. Valens ready and waiting with that scar to make his way through the upper area. And there he is, just dead set on that peak angle there, but it's smoked off. So it's like Relix is going to go in, and so Glorin as well from the vents area. It's like AZK going to take down Valens. Oh no, they're all going down, but Relix coming in from the side with the M4. Perfect timing. And the bomb will get defused. I didn't even know you could plant it all the way that far back. I've got to say, I never tried that plant.
Oh yeah, we saw... Oh no, we didn't... No, I was thinking of a different plant, actually. But that's quite interesting, because it looks like you could potentially defend that somewhat from the vent room. So, one to try out on the FACEIT pug system later on. Well, not later on.
You got work,
definitely going to pass out as soon as this match finishes.
You've worked in a few hours, please.
Yeah, I'll pass out for 2 hours, I guess. But soon after that, no, let's see.
Again.
Yeah, you're killing me, man. This is brutal. All right, so 13-10, I buy power here. It looks like we could be going down to the wire. I think I said it'll be 16-10, or was that the previous match? I can't remember.
I think it was the previous match, actually.
Yeah, I don't even know what day it is anymore.
Yep. All right, so we got the smokes going down. This is what I was talking about. The scar's really good to like spam through here in this situation, but they're going to go in straight through the smoke, in on top of the bomb site. They've got the player on back boxes to deal with. Let's see what is going to be happening here. They are flashed. They're so blind. Dumour, though, does recover just in time to take out AZK. He's still putting in a lot of work there. Gets the double. Does finally go down, but was it too much damage dealt? The bomb has not yet been planted. We got the rotation in full swing now. Hades is there. He's got his Scar brother, Valens. He's over towards mid, I think, actually. Oh, no. Yeah, he's actually towards mid, so he's going to make it happen. But look at that swag. Great little burst onto Valens. Does take him down without too much trouble. That's 14-10 now. And the money is waning for Savage. They have to eco. This is horrible. This is one of the situations where, I mean, you're really considering just going for the buy, but...
They really can't force it up here. They just don't have the money in the bank. It would be suicide. They have to eco, play for the overtime. Yeah, maybe even end up with a triple overtime. What would that be like right now?
That'd be amazing.
So, Iber Power do get the first pick, and Skedoodle, it just goes for the head. The chest is not good enough, and that's another nice pick there from Skedoodle. It's going to be two CTs remaining here, and the loss of the B bomb site for Savage to Iber Power.
And Skedoodle on fire with that AWP there. And yeah, this should be an easy plant. and Glorin and Rennick sneaking around. Sneaky BP like.
Just looking for exit frags at the moment. Glorin will probably just go for an aggressive peek, but Rennick does fall. The vent had the issue of exposing his position, good and that's a very nice headshot there from Glorin. See if he can save a weapon or still go for economic damage.
The Molotov as well.
He's got a Molly as well. He's going to be audially exposed, and Skidoodle will, sorry, Paulie will finish the job there. It's match point now for I Buy Power, so we may find ourselves, well, I mean, looking at the money on the CT side, they've got 2,735. This is going to be, okay, we've got another crash here, unfortunately, for Savage, but we're looking at a really difficult monetary situation here for the CT side, and I think this is going to be going into Iber Power's favour unless Savage pulls something crazy off.
Yeah, I mean, there is a lot that they could try to do here. It's they haven't been playing very aggro on mid. They usually just play it with one guy. You can do a lot of stuff with, like before saw before, you can get one guy kind of standing at CT connector with two kind of rushing down. You can get the smoke down really fast, pre-flash it. You could do a counter boost, or, you know, just keep the players there, play it by the information. We are going to see them split off, though, and do it completely opposite of what it says, and completely abandon mid. Of course, they are a bit afraid of these of the AWP there. But you can beat the AWP timing with proper grenades and stuff, so either way, you see Hades taking down AZK, so that's a great start to the round for Savage. There comes in the trade from Paulie. And the bomb is actually over at A main, but kind of wanting to go elsewhere, it seems now, as they are aware of this very heavy defense towards the A bomb site. Skidoodle looking to see if he can find any other players lurking around that middle area, whether it be the white box or the CT connector.
Valerian's playing up close to the Nova, but I think he's going to have someone slowly but surely creeping towards him, but we'll see who gets the better of this exchange in a few seconds, or maybe not if they choose to be a little bit more passive. The clock is running down, however, for I Buy Power. 40 seconds remaining for them to breach a site and get a bomb down. So are we going to see a connection here?
Oh no, he doesn't get the kill. Does a backflip instead, as he barely does not take down Paulie. And in they go. Just do more left with the Famas against four to try to win it. Hades doesn't believe, man. Hades doesn't believe. Gonna call the GG already, leaving his teammate out there to say, man.
Literally.
You don't have this. I don't believe it's you. Out of there. You can do this. So there's more days. Gonna get a lot of damage. Oh, that's some great pre-fire. Absolutely love it. Gonna try to switch out for the M4, but he gets killed by Skidoodle, and it's a 16-10 scoreline. Savage, they had a great game, man. Savage had a really good game against Iowa Power. Iowa Power that.